Welcome to JC Connect. In the previous class, we were discussing about the logistic curve method. In that, we have discussed the S curve, that is logistic curve. There, we have discussed the arithmetic increase method also, that is dp by dt is equal to constant. We have discussed the geometric increase method also. That is dp by dt, that is directly proportional to p, and we have discussed the saturation population also. So then how, for example, in this method what are the formulas that we are going to use in solving the problems using the logistic curve method? So the formulas are, so that is P is equal to PS by 1 plus M log to the base E to the power minus 1 and NT. This formula we have to use to calculate the population at any point of time. For example, this P, we have three terminologies already we discussed. First one, that is P naught. Then second one, we have discussed PS. Then we have discussed the P, only simple P, PS and P naught. So in the P, this P is always at any time T. For example, how we have to use this? For example, if I know the population at 2000 to 2010, then if I want to calculate it for 2011, so then I can use P at 2011. Then I have to use the formula this. This is P at any time T. This I have to use it. Then if they ask to calculate the saturation population, see, just I'll write the, what I can call, what are the terminologies normally we'll use it, using the previous curve, what we have already discussed. See, the curve is like this. You can see that up to here it will go, then it will be constant. Slowly it will be off. This shape. So normally it will be up like this, slowly. It will go like this. Try it one more time, not a problem. The normal curve is of like this. So at this point, I already explained, from this point almost it is straight line. You can see this is completely straight line. So where you are dp by dt is equal to constant. So this one is dp by dt is directly proportional to p, and up to here slowly what it will do, it will go to the parallel. So this is nothing but ps. And the starting population, this one is at this point, assume that is a point at j. This is p naught, means p naught means the population at the starting point. See, suppose if I want a p, suppose if I want the population at this point, assume that it is also p at t. Here also it is P at T. Here also it is P at T. P population at any time T. If I want to calculate it, then I'll use this. PS is nothing but saturation population. then p naught is a saturation at the starting point. Assume that there is a j. J means we have used the term here j. That is the population. Here it will be your p naught. So then this is your ps that I already explained in detail. So then k is a constant, which is for growth of always if it is a growth is a for example constant, then k will be considered as a constant. If the growth is not constant, then how exactly it is varying, then what constant we have to use it for the varying population forecasting. So t is the years. We'll discuss what is this t whenever we'll take one problem, we'll come to know. T is the years, whether 0 years or 10th years or it is 12 years or it is a 20th year, so whether it is a 30 years, so like that we have to use that. Suppose if I want to calculate the population at any time t, I have to use this. So it is already know that ps is at the numerator and the m and n are constant, very important. M and n are, these are all constant. These n are no way connected with the previous what we solved in arithmetic increase method, geometric increase method. We have used there also p naught is equal p is equal to p at any time is equal to p is equal to p naught plus nt. This is not n here, it is a different n. Don't confuse with this and the previous method what we solved. So m and n are constant. So then if you want to calculate any time t, so it is given by the expression p is equal to ps 1 plus m log e to the minus 1 to the raise to minus 1 n t. So then how exactly ps can be calculated? Then ps can be calculated with the help of 2 p naught p1 p2. Then means p naught is a zeroth at time j or at the starting point. P1 and p2 are the population at a time period of 5 years or 10 years continuously. So we'll come to know that how exactly p1 and p2 will be calculated. For example, this is what the curve. If assume that here is a p1 and here is a p2, like that. At time t, that is one decade or in second decade, like that is p1 and p2. You can consider in that way. P1 is the 10th decade or one decade. P2 will be the second decade. First decade, you can simply consider it. P1 is equal to the first decade. P2 will be the second decade. We'll come to know that how exactly these then can be calculated. So here, PS is equal to 2 P0 P1 P2. P1 square, P0 plus P2, then P0, P2 minus P1 square. Then M, how exactly we are going to calculate it? So M using this formula, PS minus P0 divided by P0. Then N is equal to 2.3 by T1 log to the base 10, P0 PS minus P1 PS and PS minus P0. So you have to remember all these formulas to calculate the population at any time t. Then we'll go ahead with the one problem. Then you'll understand what are these terminologies, how exactly it can be calculated. So this I already explained. So then this is what the one problem. Problem is the population of the city in 3 consecutive years, that is 1991, 2000 and 2011, is 80,000, 2,50,000 and 4,80,000 respectively. So then he has asked us to calculate the saturation population, that is PS. Then, and he also told us to draw a logistic curve, or you can write the equation of the logistic curve. He told us to write a equation of the logistic curve. It is nothing but that is P, whatever the thing is there. Once you substitute all the values, so what kind of equation you will get it, that you have to write. Then the expected population in 2021. So you have to calculate P at 2021. So if I want to calculate P at 2021, then I have to use this formula. So P at 2021, I have to use this formula. So then he has also asked us to calculate CPS, that is saturation population. Then you have to use this formula. If you want to calculate P at 2001, it also consists of M and N terms, small m and n terms. So then you have to use this formula as well as this formula. Then you remember all these four formulas in this logistic curve method. If you know this, that is more than sufficient. Rarely they will ask the logistic curve problem, but better to remember. So then what he has asked, so that is at the starting point P naught is at the year of 1991. It is nothing but at the year 1991. So much you take that as a P naught is equal to zero, means zeroth year, means starting point. It is nothing but at the starting point. Then this one, you remember I already said that how P naught, P1 and P2 can be calculated. So then P1 is equal to 250,000. So then that is a decade is T1 is equal to 10 years. Then P2, that is 480,000. This will be 2001. This is 2011. Then what they asked is that you calculate. So if you see the difference of 10 years from here to here, it will be 20 years. Then you take that as T2, T1 and T0. So now you understood what is T. Very important. You understood what is T. T will be the time period where the population is given. Okay. So P naught, it will be always T naught. P1 is equal to, T1 is equal to 10 years. P2 is equal to 480,000. T2 is equal to 20 years. Then PS, that is saturation. They asked us to calculate first one, that is PS. Then it can be easily computed. We know P0, we know P1, we know P2, we know. Then P1 square, that is equal to, that all the values you have to substitute here. So 2 into P0 is 80,000 into P1 is 250,000 into P2 is 480,000 minus P1 square, that is 250,000 square. 250,000 square. Then you can take the square bracket here. Then again, P naught, that is 80,000 plus P2 is 480,000. So divided by P naught is 80,000 into P2 is 480,000 minus P1 square, it is 250,000. That is all rest to square. So then if you calculate this, so you will get the 655,602. You can compute it if you want. You will get 655,602. Now what you understood by this means whatever the graph we have plotted in the above problem, you can say that this is the PS means P2 is total of 4,88,000. Then at 6,55,602, when it is going to reach that population, there it is the highest population that is totally saturated in that area. And after that, in that area, no population is going to increase. Means that is stable, that is a saturated population at that point of time. So then, of course, in this population, what is going to happen is that either the migrations or the they are going to stop the migrations, or in that saturation point of time, or what they are going to do is that due to the birth rate as well as the death rate, always at that point of time it is going to equal. See, what is going to happen is that at that point of saturation point of time, suppose if 10 people's are birth, 10 people's birth is going to happen, so 10 it is going to die. So then this population will not increase, or whether it will decrease. So that is the situation in saturated population. Then our job is to calculate the P. Then P at any time T, we have to calculate the P at 2021. So then I have to use the formula, that is P is equal to PS by 1 plus M log E to the NT. So before that, I have to calculate M and N value. So then how that can be calculated? See, first M is equal to PS by P naught, so it can be calculated. Here you can see that it is given by PS is, we already calculated that saturated population 602 minus P naught is 80,000 divided by P naught. Then so we'll get this. Then N is equal to 2 by 3, that is T1 is, we already know 10 years. We already know 10 years, then log base to the 10, P naught into PS minus P1, P1, PS minus P naught. So then it is given by 2.3. So we'll get it. You just substitute it and calculate it. How much you will get it? So minus, this is equal to minus 0.1488. Minus 0.1488, you will get it is minus, remember N is minus 0.014, that is 1488. Then to substitute the value, this M and N value, in this formula. So the P is equal to 6,55,602. Then M we already calculated, that is 7.195, multiply by log to the base E to the minus 1. Then here N, I already said that we got negative, that is minus 0.1488. And one more terminology, T is here. So then, very important this term. Why? Because T we are considering 30 years here. This we have not defined it. Why I am considering 30 years? Because from 1991, that is the P naught, is equal to up to P8 2021. So this is P8, they asked us to calculate P8 2021. So from 1991, then 2001, 2011, then 2021. So this population they have already given, that is t is equal to 0 years. Then here is your t is equal to 10 years, t is equal to 20 years. Here t is equal to 30 years. They asked us to calculate t at 30 years or 3 decades. Then here I have to substitute 30 years because I need p at 2021. Suppose if I want p at 2031, then I have to substitute the t value as 40 years. Similarly, suppose if I want p at 2041, then I have to substitute t is equal to 50 years. So do not confuse with this t here, then t0 t1 and t2. So again, inconclusively we can write it in this way: t0 0 year, t1 10 year, then t2 20 year, then t, that is 30 year in this problem. Again, it depends on the other things. So then we got the population at p at 2021 equal to 605436. So now just imagine the p at 2021 is 605436. Then p at PS is equal to 655,602. See the difference here, only 50,000 difference is there for the population of the at saturated point. Then can I plot according to that problem? What he told is that logistic curve also he told us to plot it, the equation for the logistic curve. So then what you can do, it is better you go for your Excel, better you plot it, you'll come to know how exactly it will be there. So then I'll plot the logistic curve. So I got p0, then that is there, then I got p1, I got p2, then I got p at 2021, then I got ps. So then at this point, starting point, you write what exactly the p0 is. Then p1 value you draw here at some point, assume that if it is coming here, then p2, that is p1, then assume that the p2 is coming here, assuming that value, then p at 2000, because p0 is 1991, then here it will be 2001, assume that this is p at 2011, then assume that the point is coming here. So p at 2021, and this is a point where you can see that it is ps. So then, and you try to plot this using the s curve. So just think over it, or you try to plot it in Excel. Open your there you have Microsoft Excel. So there, if you start plotting it, all these values, so definitely you will get the curve. Slightly it will be in S curve. Whatever the curve is there, it is better you draw it. If they ask in your problem, better to draw it, you draw it. So once you draw it, so you will get one equation. That is, for this, you try to fit. Maybe I'll, next class I'll show how to draw this curve in Excel, then how exactly you have to plot in the how exactly you have to draw a curve. So even you might be knowing y is equal to mx plus c. This equation you already know. So here m will be the slope and c will be the intercept. Then y will be the function of x. So it's better to try to fix or better to try to fit this curve. Of course, this is not important. But what you can do, at least you try to plot this curve, because p naught is also given, p1 is given, p2 is given, p at 2021 you calculated, and ps also you calculated it. So better you plot it in even a small, even if you take your normal graph sheets, but in graph sheets also you can draw this curve if it is linear. But if it is not linear, you have to do it in Excel only. So you'll get different equations in different forms. So better you have the graph sheet will be there like this. So better using some scale to try to plot it in your Excel. So of course, in examination, Microsoft Excel will not be there. Just place the points and try to connect. Try to connect all those points, which are the points I have given, all the five populations, P0, P1, P2, P at 2021, and PS. So this is complete about the logistic curve method. So of course, in logistic curve method, only three populations will be given. Remember, always P0 will be given, P1 will be given, and P2. So P4 will not be given. You don't have any formula related to P4 like that. Only if you just go back, only if it is they have given three decades, then only this logistic growth can be made. There's some restrictions, but if it is more than 4 decades or 5 decades, if he has given, better you select the previous 3 decades, then you go for the logistic curve method. In this way also, last time in IAS examination, it has been asked. Total they have given 5 years, so 1991, 2001, then 2011, 2021, then 2031. So he has given all these populations. Then if this is the case, then how to calculate using the logistic curve method? It is very difficult, because we have the formula. Whatever the PS or P at time t, it is only the formula related to P0, P1, and P2. Just if you see the formula. But here they have given 5. So which one I have to select it? Then what I have to do is that leave these 2 decades. Then only select last 3 decades population. So then what you have to do is that this you consider it as P0. Then you consider the P1, then you can consider P2, if that is the case. Neglect these two if they have given 5 decades population. So remember that. Neglecting these two, you can calculate it. That is how you have to calculate, or you have to use the logistic curve method. So it is better to normally, only 3 decades population will be given. He has given extra. Leave the first and consider the last 3 decades population for calculating the population forecasting using the logistic curve method. Okay. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Otherwise, we will leave.